She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me. What? Holy shit is right.
Holy shit.
Well, that helps explain the glamour. Kind of. Who is she? That wasn't there before.
Ooh.
Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
Maybe Holly knows.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
Oh, great. More for you to feel guilty about.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
Maybe not. My butt seems to disagree.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
If Snow wants to come with me, I'm not going to stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
Yep. She's a strong, independent woman who don't need no man. She's not black, but, you know, you take what you can get. Oh. So the thing is, if someone was trying
this
to make it...
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Hello, boys. 8? Or is that 9? That's 9. I'm back.
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Hide the rum. You can relax.
Okay, I know. Just relax. Not here to start anything.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, muscle Russell.
Dear, how are you?
Who is this guy? Oh my god.
Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here.
I just need to talk to Holly. Privately.
Mm-hmm. Alright, just give us a second first. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, Everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
Oh?
You said it looked like Snow White.
Not Tweedledum?
Sure it wasn't Tweedledum?
Well, no, but he seemed pretty sure.
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which, I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to...
Jack, find the off button, now!
Really?
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs.
Yeah, you didn't see the other night.
Aren't you pissed?
He's afraid I'm gonna do it again.
What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of
both of you.
Both of you. Listen.
Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Alright, that's it. I'm through. Oh.
Actually.
But!
Have there been any updates? On my sister.
Holly, your sister's dead. She's the one we found early this morning.
Damn it.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing. God fucking damn it. Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound.
Mm-hmm.
Where Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
All right, everyone. Clear out. I ain't leaving her with you. No way.
Damn. Guy's got some balls after what I did to him. He's still gonna stand up to me. Wow. That's quite admirable. Let Snow White talk to her. You know, girls time out.
Holly, get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want.
It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
What to think?
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine. It's very rare and very old.
That was decent of you.
I know. Aren't we just the greatest people around?
Yeah.
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
Yeah. Well, I don't know why these two characters remind me of something, and I can't think of what it is.
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often.
Uh-oh, buffering issues? That's no good.
She was lost here, in the city.
Oh.
She just got swept away by it. She was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. We just didn't see eye to eye on things. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
The what?
The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees. It's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Huh.
Holly, it's okay.
Puddin' and Pie, huh? What do you know about the place?
It's a real garbage dump.
We can just go check it out. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here?
Anything we can do?
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. Hmm. It's looking out for our own.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a kind of... It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise, or... I don't know.
Holly, Lily's the best evidence we have right now. We can't surrender her body till I know it can't help the case anymore.
This is really important to me.
And the investigation is important to everyone.
Look, why don't you come down with me to the business office, and we'll see what we can do.
It's tricky, man.
I'll go down there now, see what I can find out from the owner.
Getting kind of a Twin Peaks vibe from this.
Please, try to make more of an effort with her.
Yeah. Yeah, sorry about that. It was a little...
It makes everything easier.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, like, if I go to Puddin' and Pie, I expect to see, like... Like, I don't remember, in Twin Peaks, there was that club that, what's her face got caught up in? The one where her dad went in and... with her and... Anyway, never mind, this is spoilery. Hmm. Here it is. More like the pudding and cream pie. My god, so many high heels, man. Just everybody.
Oh, Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before.
Yeah, nice ribbon.
You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure?
I'm looking for someone.
Finding you someone is our specialty, but the club's closed.
Not quite what I meant.
That's too bad. I guess you'd better talk to Georgie. You're in luck. He's here. Come on.
Whew, that's good. Nice posters.
I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now.
Define working.
I mean, more so than usual.
Is he, alone in there?
He's working with one of the dancers, but don't worry about that. Discretion is our guarantee.
Okay. I don't know what I'm about to see. Look, these walls, they're like... they look just like the other place. Oh my god.
Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community.
Are we getting raided?
Our pleasure.
Dear god.
Your desires are our desires. Your imagination is the menu, and discretion is our guarantee.
Luca Jin just raided with my dick. And oh my god, there's so many of my dicks. Oh, I've never seen so many dicks. Alright, let's celebrate with some music. Thank you, Luca Jin, for the stream. Oh my god, this is just going on. Your dick is very long, apparently. It also lasts very long.
You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that.
You look like you're trying to take a shit.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good.
Right on.
Good luck.
Choo Choo, what's up? Oh my god, I'm so glad.
You have to smile. You never smile. How many times do I have to say it?
Yeah, well.
You're supposed to turn the clients on. That's your job.
Dude, it's that song. I know that song.
You want them to think you feel happy. You want them to forget about your shoulders and those. Oh, it's you.
The figures Luca Jin comes in here with my dick. And there's this! Those boobs! What? The toilet flushes! What else could happen?
Stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down. We're not finished.
Yeah. Ooh, this is bad.
I'm a busy man.
I don't know.
What do you want, then? You here for a little taste?
Another toilet flush?
Come back after midnight.
Are you kidding me, man?
I can hook you.
Mayo, hello, for 2 months in a row.
Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer
and I missed somebody
to
else.
Take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target, or one that will put up a fight?
I'm not here for that.
You can arrange whatever you like, for the right price.
I'm not here for that.
Oh, I'm not here for that. Just stopped in for the chips, then. Jesus, Big B.
Okay, I see my own hello. I'm trying to figure out who the other one was.
No, seriously, I love it.
So I'm gonna have to... Here.
Okay, alright, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Yeah. Who told you?
Who told you?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I...
Oh, the other was Luca? Oh my god.
Of course he was.
Luca Jin, thank you so much.
No, I mean glamour to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what? Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching.
It's sick.
Yeah, sick.
Especially coming from you.
The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. Strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting. This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. but you've got fuck all to back it up.
Ugh.
And we're all just meant to jump anytime the wolf shows his teeth. He used to be something, you know. Now look at him. Get that out of my face.
This was part of the glamour we found on Lily's body. Take a good look. She was impersonating Snow White. Why?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway,
oh God.
Not to do with me. Go on, then.
Here we go again. Well, it is like animated, sort of, so it's not really... We're not done here.
We're not done here.
I think we are.
I said we're not.
You're gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you want to do, right? That's what you came here for, right?
Tell me what I want to know, or I'll shut this whole place down.
Oh, no, fuck!
Haha.
You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it! Bloody bastard fucking shit!
Well...
You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess?
I didn't do anything. You knocked it over. Wow.
Fuck off, Hans.
Sorry, Hans. Hans Gilderson.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans Olo?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Huh. Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in it?
You're a fucking moron.
Show me.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start.
What is that?
Hey, that's my personal property.
Smash it.
Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
I will. Just you wait. Oh, I love this scene. I love the cinematography on this. There is another toilet. Another one. Boom!
Oh no! You unbelievable prick!
ARJH3214, thank you for the subscription. And welcome to the bathroom. Break cigarette machine. There's one for you. Here's one for Luca Jim. And one for Mayo. Hello.
You shouldn't have messed with that. Don't even think about it.
I'm on a roll here.
Jesus fuck! Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
There's still time for you to just cough it up.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but there's no Andy magic book with everything you want to know jotted down inside. I sincerely wish there was. Maybe it would get you off me back.
Oh?
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I don't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
I don't like the word hurt. Fuck it.
Oh, was it good for you, Sheriff? Next time, I'm gonna have to charge you. Jesus, you're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Two women are dead.
Then quit being a bloody idiot. Come on, Nate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
Oh, shit.
This is a dance club. What the hell am I supposed to do tonight while the girls are on stage? Harmonica, kazoo, whistle a happy tune. Fucking unbelievable.
Kazoo?
Bloody come on, men. fucking trespass my business over this bullshit? Protector of Fable Town, my ass. What a load of crap.
Man, I don't even know anymore.
Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so he can be happy about that.
So there was a book. Well, let's see.
This is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Hans knows that.
207?
Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book. Your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage. I give them music. I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint.
Thought I saw somebody back there.
Hello, business office.
Dude, I'm gonna trash your phone while I'm at it. Jeez. Oh. Well. Nothing in her cubby.
Isn't even a lock.
Well, that is weird. There was like money on the floor. Did I look at this?
Lock's been busted open.
Uh-oh.
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter.
Dude, at least pick up the 50 cents. Leonardo, Donatello.
Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients.
Huh. Okay, well, Yikes. Oh, it seemed like it was. Did I do this already? Oh, it was just that. Boy, there's getting to be a lot going on here. It's getting pretty deep. Whatever. Excuse could be. Me. Oh.
I heard
it's you.
There.
Oh my god, it's Beauty.
I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
Oh, trust me, you would never normally see me in here.
I'm here now.
Yes.
So they all wear those ribbons, apparently,
you're
around their necks.
You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Whoa, wait, what?
Once upon a time. Does that help?
Once upon a time.
You have legs. Had a glamour?
No, they're real. Do you like them? They cost me a lot.
But
my name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Not Ariel?
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Of course. I figured as much.
Did you see Lily last night?
Oh, dear God.
Where she went or who she was with?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
Cyrus Truewith, thank you for the subscription.
These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee.
These lips are sealed. And here's one for you.
Things work here. By design.
People keep using those phrases. What does it mean?
tomb.
This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
Look, I'm not here to bone you. I'm not here to jack off to you. What I'm here for... What are you suggesting?
What exactly are you suggesting?
I don't think she's suggesting that, actually.
We could make all the usual arrangements. The usual place.
Oh!
I see. What would I need to do?
Yeah, just jot your name down.
150. It's not good to be short.
No, it sure isn't. A pair. Damn, dude, you're slick. Oh my Jesus Christ! These toilets are going crazy in here. I don't know whether this is a strip club or a shit club at this point. Mr. D1718 for 2 months in a row. That is fucking amazing, as per usual. Thank you so much for the subscription. You know, in the bathroom. I actually said the right thing for a change.
Not 207?
That's Lily's room.
You'll think of something.
Oh.
Open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay.
It's where they journeyed, apparently.
I hope you find what you're looking for.
Get it? Journey? Open arms? Sorry. So I'm supposed to, like, go and break into 207. That was her way of giving me directions there without actually having to say anything. So it won't be her fault that I went to 207. Oh my gosh. What's going on here? It's that guy from Life is Strange. It sure looks like him. Oh no, oh my god, he's black. I am so sorry. Something about the shading was off, I guess. Another toilet! Now I can hear the toilets from all the way outside the building! The Moon Queen has just subscribed. Thank you so much, so much. So I lisped. Apparently I don't know how to lisp. You know, in the bathroom. This is way too much. 10! That's number 10! That's half a pack. I hope you can afford that. Cola. Of course, you just gave 150 bucks to a girl, I suppose. We should look around. Let's see here. Super cola.
She'll kill ya.
He says just before taking a drag. Jeez, man. Missing?
Probably repair that.
Oh. It's the phone.
Let's see here. Bobby, they should cut their rates.
Whoa, what was that a map of over there? It looked like New Jersey. Can I walk over there and see? I seriously doubt it, but I can just look good for the camera. Hey guys, what's up? There's toilets in here too. Oh my god, there's so many toilets flushing right now that I can't even breathe. Who was that? Jamie Lynn! J-A-M-I underscore L-Y-N-N has just subscribed. Why did I spell your name out? I guess I was worried that people wouldn't know who I was talking about. Thank you and welcome to the bathroom. Boom. Just like that. Trying to be keeping the neighbors up all night with that bell. But I certainly can't complain. Open arms. Serious? What? I can't even... What the hell? Is this serious right now? Maximo, thank you for the subscription. Welcome to the bathroom, and here is yours. Make sure to wipe on the way out because I don't want... it's too late. The smell's already there. I guess I can't help that. Hell, you can even see it. He rung the bell! Wow, oh my god!
Oh,
you.
There's Beauty.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent.
You're not the stripper.
Now you know.
I can't believe he rung the bell. There's no way I can keep up.
But Beast,
oh my God,
would lose his mind if you knew.
I won't say anything.
Beast is a proud man, Bigby. He wants
to
do
right
by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted.
Well, your secret's safe with me, all right? Let's not make a big thing of it.
Thanks, Bigby. And thanks for covering for me last time, too.
Yeah, no problem.
So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Yeah.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh. Lily?
Oh, yes. The troll.
Mm-hmm.
I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Yeah. Ever see Lily with anyone?
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job.
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
Well, this would have been like in the last few days.
Or someone named Mr. Smith.
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
I was gonna make the joke myself, and then you just did it for me. Thank you, though. Do you know Faith?
You meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know. By the end of the night, it's kind of a blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather... Sorry.
Yeah. Courtney, LaChandria, LaFonda, Barbisha.
I talked to Tweedledee earlier today.
Clitorisandria.
Passing. Do you know him or his brother?
I took out a loan for back pay. It was like our third notice. And ever since then, those annoying freaks have been pestering me for the money plus interest.
Why take out a loan from those two?
It was from the crooked man.
Beauty.
You don't know how desperate I was, Bigby. I had nowhere else to go.
Look,
okay.
If this ever happens again, come see me or Snow first, all right?
I tried.
Oh, boy. That's like a... Have you seen Snow here?
I've seen Snow White down here. Or maybe somebody glamored as her.
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her.
Oh.
I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
And it wasn't.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
5 minutes, please.
We'll see. Beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Sure. Hopefully nothing else will be hard either. Achievement unlocked. Maybe? Can I get a fresh
I'll
set of towels?
Be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine. It's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just...
You're asking me to lie.
No, we can hear that's going on in those rooms.
Include my name. Just say you talk to the clerk or something. You'll do what you have to. I just want you to know that that would help me. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
It was 207. Is it 204, 35? So it would be this one. Hear all that action. Nobody's gonna be in there. But we can listen. Put our ear up to the door. Listen, baby. Unless you put your ear to the ground, you never hear the buffalo coming. Must I kick it in? Or I can just...
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. Seriously, what if someone found out? I could get into a lot of trouble.
You have to let me in there. This is the room, 207.
But I...
This is the room Lily was in.
Uh-oh. Fine.
Oh, boy.
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit. Shit.
Beast?
Big B?
How
did
no.
you do this to me?
Oh, God, no.
Sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
It's not like that.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love...
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me. With him?
No.
I promise.
He's going to turn into a beast.
Helping him. That's all.
Oh, God.
Bet. I'm sure you help each other just great.
You've got it wrong.
It's not what you think.
There's
Stop
no reasoning with him.
Me.
He's losing it.
What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me. There's nothing going on. I'm mad.
Hey.
Oh, God.
I guess I finally see you for who you are.
Stop. Stop
No.
It.
No.
Is this you staying out of it?
I don't want to hurt you, so just calm down and...
Beast.
Please. No! Shit, I pressed the wrong button. I pressed A.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You aren't listening to
Oh
me.
God, oh God,
She's my wife, Bigby!
Use the right finger. Use the right finger. What? What's that? Okay. I pressed A and D at the same time. And it worked. Oh, this again, huh? A? Jesus Christ.
Leave it be! This is my fault!
No.
Please,
no. I can't stand. Dude! Whoa, did I pressed W. Q? Q? This is cute! No, over there. Crap. I just gouged out his eyes! Dude. I have to. It's telling me to.
No, don't hurt him!
No, we've had enough. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna regret it. Fuck. Oh, God. What's now? What now?
You ruined everything!
I didn't. I have to stop it. Okay. That's one way to get the door down. Thanks, Beast. You helped me get the door down.
Shit, Big B.
What have you done?
What is this? Big B.
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you-
Stand back! You don't want to see this.
Oh, boy. Oh, that's messed up. Stay outside.
Beauty, stay in the hall.
What? Why? What's going on?
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here, Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Oh, man.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
Do you remember who rented this room last night?
I don't think anyone did. Not last night. Maybe they have it long term. I don't know. How am I supposed to know? It just seemed like a totally normal night.
Maybe there's like records or something.
Possible. There's so much blood.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But
just do what he says. I'll explain later. Okay.
But I can't even see. He gouged my eyes out. I can't believe he's just walking away like, oh.
What kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
Yeah, baby. Well, holy jeez, man. I can't believe it either. I'm actually going to, before I start investigating the room, I'm actually going to go to another intermission. So sorry about that. But then I suppose this is what we do. Oh my God, I'm so dumb. I'll be back in a little bit. What did I, oh, ugh, that is right. so uncertain about myself sometimes. Good lord.
Thank you.
Okay, we are seriously like that. Oh, there it goes. Oh no. So trying to grab some record keeper in here in between. Go. All right then. We're gonna minimize this, and we're gonna. Jeez, can I? Thank you. Good lord, man. All right. Set this back to that. And boom. Yeah. So I'm gonna start by looking at whatever this is. We shouldn't even be in here.
Smell something?
No. Yeah, you know, in the bathroom. Jeez. It's an apple with a bite taken out. Oh, well, there. Big surprise one of those is in here. Try the book.
What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
Those muggles. Can't even read this. Oh.
The book is about her?
Yeah.
What is it?
He has a food fetish. He likes to see snow in peril.
I think he bookmarked this picture because it shows snow in peril. And he likes that.
You mean like a danger fetish?
Something like that.
Okay, so he's basically just crazy. Which, yes, no big surprise there.
Dude, turn that down. Just don't give it away. Well... Well, geez, not that much danger.
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
Oh. Or maybe like she's dead, but not really dead. You know, kind of like the real one. Yeah. Maybe he's into all that suffocation or shit. I don't know, that's kind of gross, though.
God.
God.
He brought wine.
Classy.
Mm-hmm. Very classy. More like assy. What? The tape's somewhere in the middle of it. Yeah, I just pocketed that. Keep that around for later. Is somebody gonna jump out of this closet too? Oh, jeez.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no. She must have been wearing it. He killed her, and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
Maybe her boobs were so big they just busted out of it.
What are you thinking?
Oh, man.
He found Lily wearing something else, tailored after one of Snow's suits. It's possible that the dress is actually for Mr. Smith himself.
Okay.
Like
I
said, the boobs
knocked
it out.
Of course, we already know the guy's a freak. Jesus, that poor girl. What did she walk into? She could
Maybe she walked into his boobs.
She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
Georgie took advantage of her when she was in trouble. He's a real predator.
Yeah. She must have been so scared.
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not.
Well, if it's your brand, you probably couldn't smell it because you'd be so desensitized to it. I think I'm all done here. Let's check myself out.
Get it together, beauty. Be strong.
Oh, I can walk. I almost forgot I could walk. Wow, definitely examine the bed.
Looks like lying down when she was killed. Flowers were already here.
How do you know that?
Blood pattern. Also, I'd say the body was dragged off the foot of the bed. There.
The body. Jesus. You could say she. Poor girl. I just can't even imagine.
Well, you're talking to Dexter here.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
I told you not to come in here, but you wanted to know, so...
Bigby!
I'm thinking...
I'm wondering if this might be a ritual killing. The bed looks like an altar, the way it's been set up deliberately with the flowers all around it. Victim lying down, no apparent struggle. Looks like some kind of sacrifice.
Ugh.
Oh God, sacrifice? This just gets weirder and weirder. God, this is all too weird, Bigby. Who is this guy? The whole ritual sacrifice thing? I'm not sure what to do with. I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer.
Well, if you walk out, you're gonna probably get a question from the old boss man, like, hey, where did you go? You were on shift, and you just left with that police guy. One more little thing here.
Stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer.
Is Snow herself?
What is it?
It's Crane.
What?! And he knows that we found out. Oh, jeez. Are you serious?
He could be after you now.
Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
Amen to that. Oh, it froze for a second there. Oh my God. Why in the world? Oh, that is so fucked up.
I like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
No, yeah, you remember what I did last
Obviously,
time.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
That guy's funny.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Oh, damn. That elevator shut, Sean.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?
Dude. Whoa. I think I just hit my evolution. My mega evolution, rather. How did you respond to Crane about Snow's death? Ignored him. How did you treat the murder suspect? Mm-hmm. 30% of players hit Georgie. Did you keep punching Beast when he was down? Most people didn't. Well, that's good. Oh, jeez, man. Okay, so, please don't stop now. No, please don't stop. Oh, I'm afraid episode 3's cliffhanger might be even worse than that one, though. And I'm stretching like a madman! Oh, man. Oh, God. You know, it's weird because I kind of sort of had a feeling. Earlier when we were talking to him, I didn't really say anything because I thought, well, that would be kind of... I mean, almost kind of cliche, but not really. Maybe that's the very reason that you wouldn't be expecting it. But still, just... Oh! But that being the case, now we know... Well... I mean, it's too early for us to have solved this whole thing, right? Like, there must be more to it than that, though. The next chapter is quite long. Oh, is it? Yeah, don't stop believing. Well, let me see. I mean, I started at, what, 7? Well, more like 7:30, because the game was still downloading, but I figure 7:30 to 11:10, that was like less than four hours to do the first two. Well, am I really feeling it? Hell yeah. Oh, and someone in the chat earlier said, about the Gumshoe music, was I ever going to change it? Yeah, I was actually planning to change it sooner than this, to be honest, but it didn't cross my mind. Like, last time I, you know, like, changed the intermission, I had some trouble with, like, editing and stuff. So, but yeah. But I already have an idea what the next song is going to be, and people are going to hate it, too. Oh, they're going to hate it. But I will say this, it is another Phoenix Wright song, so if that is any consolation. This is a perfect time to end the stream. Yeah. I wonder if you'll do a bit of PVZ2 live one of these days. Last one and then 4 and 5 tomorrow. Oh god, no, I don't know about... Tom has been playing Mega Man 1 for over 4 hours. What the hell's taking him so long? I'm just kidding. Enjoying The Wolf Among Us, Tim? Hell, yes I am. Well, this is crazy. Like, I don't know. Usually I don't like games with this sort of vibe, this setting, but this is damn good. Look at those yellow eyes, man. Am I uploading this to YouTube? No, probably not. I don't think so. Because, it's like, I'm barely going to have time to edit what I am uploading, which is, like, Final Fantasy VIII and Aria of Sorrow. Where are you going to use Feel So Good for the intermission? Feel So Good? Oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness, goodness gracious. If Tom's experience with Mega Man 1 is anything like mine, spikes are the reason. Yeah, I could see that. There's certain ones, like in the... I mean, even in, like, in the Bomb Man stage, that one section towards the end. It's real problematic. I'd say definitely. YouTube is really shy right now, anyways. I'll have this one then. Yeah. The Juka. How far has Tom got in Mega Man? I'd actually be interested to go watch some of that. Of course, I could always watch the VOD. I'll just bump this next thing. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start the next chapter tonight, but I'm just kind of talking with people for a little bit here. In between. Because I like to do that. Oh, whoa, whoa. Oh, yeah, yeah. Hey, Sarah Bear, I didn't realize you were here. Good to see you. Glad to have you with us. How far did he get into the boss rush? Oh, did he make it to the boss rush? Well, that's damn good. The boss rush is the worst part of it. Just sitting here, going through the... sitting here playing the stupid Final Fantasy Record Keeper. Just trying to get my stamina down so it's not sitting there full. I want his head. Kill Crane! I won't be uploading it to my own YouTube, but you might be able to see it in the future on this YouTube link that I'm about to post in the chat in another few seconds here. Oops. But it actually takes a lot of time to get those up and, like, downloaded and then sent over there and whatever, so... So I can't say with any certainty when it would be up, but if it does go up, that's where it's going to be. Sorry, me and John got you hooked on record. Dude, don't apologize. This game is fun as hell. Champion. All right. Glad I got Champion on one of those. All I got to do is one more, and that should be enough to keep it good for the next whatever. So all I gotta press is like 3 buttons here. Oh geez, it's boss. We're doing the boss now. We can save that. Yeah, it's 11 stamina, big deal. Alright. Here we go. Yeah, but I'm telling you. If you're ever in Pomeroy, Ohio, there's an Exxon station on Dead Man's Curve Road that sells awesome footlong hot dogs, fully loaded for $1.29. Jeez.
This awful city. Everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
Yep.
Snow? I just want you to be careful.
I don't know what that was all about.
I almost lost you once.
Just want you to be careful.
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister Lily.
Holly Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
Oh, don't show that
My
again.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my god. What is it?
It's Crane.
Oh, he was reaching up there and everything. Ugh. If you wanted to sacrifice somebody, you could just do it. You know, you didn't have to. Oh, so nasty. That piece of shit. I'll kill him, fucking creep.
I'll kill him. I'll rip him apart.
Crane? Ugh. God, you think you know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know.
Yep.
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
Crane's the killer.
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Wait a minute.
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down.
What if it was like...
Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
I have to tell Snow what's going on right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say
where
she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the train trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The train trap? Are you drinking?
When? Right now. They were on their way out.
Great time for that to come up.
Bigby!
A bee!
Wait!
A big bee! No.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her.
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
But it wasn't her, right? Just like is it possible that maybe it's not him? If you can just glamour a person. Kind of makes you wonder. Of course, maybe you can only do girls, but I don't know. Uh-oh. This looks like a dungeon.
Honored to be asked to speak to you. She met everyone's name. Lily had many friends, but few fables she was truly close to.
It's the funeral. Port a toilet. Right here.
People she trusted and cared for.
Damn, you're looking good.
I won't, offend you by claiming one day that... the pain of losing Lily will ever subside. I know as well as you that it will never subside. But I also know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well. And it will, in time, equal in strength to our mourning her loss. And it is in that spirit that I'd like to talk about what you've all been so grateful to share with me. Your memories of her. How she could be stubborn and patient, rash and thoughtful, how she carried a torch for the old ways, for tradition, for, pageantry. And most of all, it seems how Lily loved, dearly loved, her friends and family. She loved being around them, in good times and bad. I never met Lily, but from what I've been told, I know in my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight. And now we'll have our, moment of silence. Thank you.
Okay. Moment of silence, because I haven't talked for the last 3 minutes, so... No, not right now, she says. Okay, fine. Sit down. Can I sit down? Maybe I'll just walk around. Yeah.
Bigby, is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here. After you
say
lie,
what?
And you say you need her for evidence.
Holly, wait, that was Crane, just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help, and I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one
isn't. Oh boy, you have no idea.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else.
We should.
What? No, I deserve to know.
Oh, well, you do.
No, I know, but this isn't the way to go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way. I don't care about procedure. If anyone should be told, it's me. It's us, right now. So talk.
I came here to talk to Snow about this.
No, screw that. My sister's dead, and I don't give a shit who she looked like when it happened. It's not about her. It's about Lily.
Just tell us who it was.
Okay, everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while everyone else gets back to the funeral.
Back to the future.
I'm not just gonna sit here.
Please, I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first.
Look, this is our jobs.
I know how this
must careers first,
you
know.
You don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly. Nothing more.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
Man, oh man. So awkward. Funerals are never good. But especially not when...
Okay, you think you know who the killer is. What have you got? Bigby?
Lily was Crane's prostitute. I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing?
I got the pictures.
Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things.
Yeah. I got pictures. I shouldn't be showing this to her, but...
You took a cab here, right?
Yeah.
I'll drive. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
Oh, crap. Am I going to have to make this decision?
I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
Oh, take your time.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
I don't need Holly any more pissed off at me than she already is.
How'd it go? At the motel?
Oh, trust me.
Did you find anything?
You do not want to know.
It was Crane's room. But you knew that already, right?
But you knew that already. And he wasn't supposed to go at an angle, yeah, but he did.
Coming!
Somebody's gonna let it spill over there.
Constable?
Wait, shit.
Easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do?
Now is really not the time for whatever you jerk-offs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular...
Who in the world told you that?
We'll leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No. See now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention.
I'm doing that.
So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours?
Brother,
speak your mind. Fastly now. What's it gonna be?
Just don't hurt anyone, D.
That don't sound like a yes to me. Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Shoot.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
Settle down. Settle down now.
Stop this shit. Right now.
He hasn't exactly been a good sport about this. Not making our lives any easier.
But... No! What is this?
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly?
You motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
You tell that asshole.
It's just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
I'm just gonna let this play out.
Listen to your lady, love. Things don't have to turn sloppy now.
Oh, man.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
Oh.
I'm gonna kill you!
Here we go. Oh my god. Oh, what?
I got it, damn.
It's all Q, Q, Q. Wait for whatever comes next. Oh! Oh, jeez! Everybody's dead! Everybody's dead! Game over. I guess we get to have two funerals today. Oh boy! Whoa! I think I just really fucked something up there. Oh god, just when you think things can't get any worse, you know, then somehow they do. Oh boy. Man, somebody has got to slice those Tweedledicks up into turkey breastises and make some sandwiches. Wow. Am I just suddenly... This choice is blank. This choice is... What? What? That was weird. Wait, I just randomly walked onto another screen there. There we go. Oh. Who is this? Is that a mannequin? I can't talk to you. Am I dreaming? Oh no. I can't seem to talk to these guys. Why am I like out here with no shirt on? In the business office. Where am I going? Jeez. This is a little weird. I'm not gonna lie. I can't even walk that way. This guy is like that guy in the Sonic Adventure that you can just pick up and carry around. He reminds me of that guy. Here's our little research hub here. Oh, there's more. Maybe. Examine. Oh, he's rushing over to her now. I'm like in the center of everything. What is under here? Is this a ball? Is this my balls? My game is bugged. Restart. Oh, okay, okay. Escape. Let us exit the game. Okay, I'm not sure how that happened, but, yeah, sorry about that. I looked away for too long, and I should have, Oh, there's nothing I could have done to prevent what happened at the funeral. Okay. I guess that's kind of a relief. Oh, wait, it's doing something. It's, like, updating. It's at 96% though, so... Okay. Now that it's done that, let's try it again. That was pretty weird. I had a feeling, like, right from the beginning that something was off there. Alright, well, thank goodness I got you guys here to tell me this, because I wouldn't have known what to do there. I mean, I guess eventually I would have quit and Googled it and found out, but... Like, if I just happened to be playing it by myself one random day. Tim, you donate? Oh, you donated. Sweet. Finn Balor, 1993. Thank you so much. I'd love to go in and, like, look at those, but... I mean, I suppose I could. Well, I'll do that, like... When we finish out here. Episode 3 continue. Well, I hope I didn't, like... A crooked mile. Oh, here we go. Okay, now we got this one.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
I can do that.
Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water.
Oh, so they're okay then?
They're titans, Bigby. They'll be fine. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
Wow. I was about to say something there, but... Oh.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back.
The 2 looks like a 9 on that phone, which is why I thought the numbers were scrambled up before. Out.
Well, I'll leave you 2 to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
See ya. That doctor was like the guy in Sonic Adventure.
So, to recap.
Recap! He watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So...
This is not like the Doors and Monsters Incorporated. I don't think that's gonna work.
But I don't know.
Any other leads?
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him, I get it, but do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible to me.
I don't know what to say.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks
you be careful
tonight,
there.
By the way, that could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake.
Well, but at least we got to see her Jasper form for a little bit there.
Can I, ask you a question?
Sure.
It's kind of personal.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
I don't want to offend you.
What's on your mind?
After tonight.
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home.
Huh.
And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Ugh, once again, I'm lost.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Guys? We have a problem.
Yeah?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Oh.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
Bufkin, are you positive it's not here? Maybe it just slid under one of these cabinets.
No, I'm sure it's not here. I checked every corner. I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea.
Oh, so that's the plan from our great leader, huh? Just sit here on our butts.
Is an option.
No. We can't depend.
What's the hard way?
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that.
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Oh boy. Poor little monkey. After all that work.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snowblammers from.
Oh. The black market witch. See anything else?
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
It's not your fault.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
I wonder if I shouldn't
you do that.
It seems like a dickish thing to say, oh, why didn't you stop him? I mean, he's just a little flying animal that could fly circles around him and probably stick him with a lightsaber like Yoda. But call Robin Williams, who is inside the magic lamp. Oh boy, we got some letters here. Yeah, that's kind of how I feel about it too, but well. Waylon Smith. Okay, these are letters to Crane. This form should not be a punishment, huh? Well, what about number two here? I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up in this apartment. And Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. So I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross and I'd really like it if you'd fix the air. Like we asked you 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. And finally, Mr. Crane, you said you'd pay to have the plaster redone in my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the freaking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. But you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. But guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together, Mr. Toad. Well.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Yep, apparently that's Crane's career. You can hear it right now, just going down the toilet. Thank you, Blood Ocean 07, for your steadfast support over the years. Here is your ring, my man. Get some more toilet paper. 207, the key.
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
The real key.
You still haven't told me what was in there.
Oh, man.
I want to know. I need to know.
Alright, I'll be blunt with you.
Paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together. Forgive me if I spare you the details.
Duh.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside.
All those times that he looked at my ass.
So much you can repress, you know?
How many times was he taking a mental note to put into a spank bank for later? You couldn't have known.
You couldn't have known.
No, I could have. Come on, let's keep looking.
Well. Into the drawer we go. The Office of Business Affairs, official something. Compendium of Authorized somethings.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah?
The ring.
Bufkin, do you know what was here?
The ring.
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in
the armory, the bakery, the armory, the bakery, the armory, the bakery.
Is going to see.
Wait, what witch?
Bufkin overheard Crane set up a meeting with a witch.
Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. It must be about this ring.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover, I'm sorry.
Oh.
He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So,
oh, man.
Find the dull pervert or not.
Boy, this guy's head, you can just tell by how shot...
No, and frankly, it's none of your business.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he's foiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
Who was that?
If he's the murderer.
Finn Balor, 1993. Boom.
Look.
Welcome to the bathroom.
He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you care?
Why do you?
You're looking a little suspicious right now.
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town. Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight,
yeah,
the Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him.
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none
Damn.
Of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well, then. Excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Well, take the Commonwealth and flush it down the toilet.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
Yep.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few okay. shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah, yeah. Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
Yeah, those butt munches.
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down.
Shoot, I was gonna say I can always do both.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't
Wait, what?
Just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock. I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
Jeez.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence.
You're not going anywhere.
You're not going anywhere.
Really now? And what? You gonna stand here and babysit me? While the rest of your leads evaporate into mist?
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions.
Oh, Lordy.
This is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now.
No, but... here comes a big decision. I can feel it. This one's big. Find the witch. We can look at the... Oh, wow.
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy, and I don't need charity.
Oh, jeez. Oh my god, there's three places. Well, crawling in my skin. These words. Anyway. Oh, goodness. Well, okay, my first thought was, well, they said... Oh, no, we're running out of time, aren't we? I feel like Crane's apartment is an obvious choice, but maybe too obvious. And I think Holly's bar was actually my first thought, because she would know, she may be able to get us a lead on who. Well, that's the thing though, wait a minute. Well, the person who had changed Lily into the other, the person who gave Lily the glamour is not Crane. Crane is just the one that had sex with her. He had somebody else doing the glamour thing. So maybe we need to actually, like, start at the bottom here and work our way up rather than trying to go straight for number one. But then there's this, like, we know these guys are in on it somehow. Colinus the Great, thank you for the host! I thought I turned hosting, alerts off so it didn't pop up when somebody did that, but okay. Can't say I object now. Your vote is on Holly's bar, so is mine, to be honest.
The witch's identity must be with Lily's stuff. I should go see Holly first.
Perfect. And I'll go to Crane's apartment.
I'll check in with you later. I hope you know what you're doing.
Well, that's good, because I don't. I don't know shit. Trip trap bar, baby. Sorry, we're closed on account of funeral. 1 hour and 22 minutes left, what the...
He's asleep, you fucking idiot. He didn't even give me a chance to explain. What do you have to explain?
Guys, it's me, Bigby.
Hey, dude.
Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Why were you so happy about...
Brent, what? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search
of... What's wrong with you?
Hospitality, right?
Just what in the fuck is wrong with you?
Nothing's wrong with me. In fact, I'm in a good goddamn mood. So you should take advantage.
This guy is so cool. I'm so sorry I chopped your arm off, dude. This guy, on the other hand...
Anybody else want a drink?
Yeah.
Brent,
well, I like him too, though.
Said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
I'm sorry about that.
Brent, you shouldn't drink right now.
Where's Lily's stuff?
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Have you seen Lily's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral?
Oh, no.
Is that stuff supposed to be here, or...?
Nope, haven't seen it.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really?
Really?
The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
Nice. I can go for some of that.
And he said
no,
that
not
he
really.
Mix it with
not alcohol. Really. What are you doing?
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
You sure you don't know where Lily's things are? You should care about this, since it's important to the case.
What did I tell you before? I'm sure I don't know.
Don't do that.
That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay?
Oh, boy.
Can't say you being there helped things much. Grant.
Well, I wasn't exactly...
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
I don't care what you think.
I couldn't give a shit what you think. No?
No.
Well, I can tell.
What's that all about?
It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it.
Too out of it to get into it.
I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all going to have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. I know. And I want to help you, okay?
Got 1 hour and probably 18 First, minutes now.
Indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't fine. Want to get loaded with him. To the dead.
To the dead. I'll drink some water.
All right, now help me.
It's good.
Gren, the doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back.
Jeez.
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it. It's done.
Oh, boy. Oh, God.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
I absolutely cannot babysit you dumbasses right now. Do whatever this is, so we can just move past it. Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly what? Had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal.
Jeez.
It wasn't. Well, I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
Wow. Oh, fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Is that a beer can stain on your shirt?
Teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a
Woody,
shit.
Woody, I have questions.
Wait, I've got some questions for you. What possible questions could you have for this piece of
oh,
shit?
Oh, no. Trust me, I know.
Everything's a problem when I want to talk. But when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh, wait, I have questions.
What do you want? When you saw Lily, did she ever mention anything about a witch?
No. We didn't talk about work.
All right.
Thought I had something there.
Grim.
I wonder if I would have with the other option.
I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the role. The ogres, too.
I thought you said you would help me look.
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
There he goes. The Grim won't remember this. Now that he's passed out, he's kind of made me feel like I'm gonna pass out. Just kidding. Not really. But I'm very good at pretending, as you may have noticed. I don't know why she's still in her Jasper form, but I shouldn't even mess with her. Oh, jeez. No, please don't wake up. Please, don't fart. Well, you just did. Too bad. Seriously, you don't... Why suddenly a long one like that, you know? This reminds me of, like, in Robin Hood, when he's sneaking the bags out, and Sir Hiss is sleeping, and he's like... Of all the things, it's gonna end up being this... Damn. I know. Oh, don't...
Is that you, Woody? Woody?
Yeah, sure. It's me.
Sure.
Woody, bar's closed. And Lily ain't around anyway, so... You can run off back to the woods, I guess.
Cheeto farts. Who is this girl on the right? Damn.
Did you care about her at all? She was a nice girl. Ran around too much.
Of course I cared. I still care.
I hope so. I hope you do.
Please don't open your eyes too wide. Why is this here? Was this... Oh, this was that thing. Do I get to unlock another one? Maybe not.
I don't know why you fucking came here.
Nowhere else to go.
For you to ruin. And I'm not in an entertaining mood.
Go back to sleep. Shit. Took too long to reach for the mouse. Maybe it's better that I didn't say anything. Okay, there's this here. Just like when Daniel's looking at Mr. Miyagi's things. Okay, address book. This is what we want.
Lily's funeral. It was just so fucked tonight. But I still wish you could have been there. Yes. I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit. I don't know. I don't know why he showed up. I just wish he'd get out of my fucking life.
Jeez.
He's trying to do what's right.
You think so?
Yeah.
I know so. And you'll believe anything I say.
You know him better
because you're half asleep.
So, I guess I'll take your word for it.
That's so gross, that horn coming out of the under cheek. Shit. Close the book and run.
If you were getting your glamour on this day, one of these has to be the witch. But, which one?
Maybe the one on Dahlia Lane?
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there?
Hello.
If you're there, pick up, okay?
I'm here. I'm running the bar now.
Snow?
Hey, I just wanted to see how it was going. Did you find anything?
Just sure did. Address book with her contact's initials. Not sure which one is the witch, though.
Strange. These people keep cropping up. Before, a few days ago, I thought I knew everyone in Fieldtown.
Any chance you can cross-reference these with the records in the business office? Maybe track
that's
it
what I was
that
thinking.
Way.
Yeah, but who knows how long that'll take. You should try going up to Crane's place. I sent Buffkin up there to check on things. Bluebeard, you know. Or you could try at the Tweedles office. Just make it quick.
Yeah, I could.
We don't have a lot of time.
Yeah, I know. We sure don't. The meeting is at 2. I'm gonna check out Dean Dome's office.
Dean's place. See what I can find there.
Might as well save the prime suspect for last. He is the final boss, after all.
See what I can do on this end.
Okay.
Good luck, Bigby.
We'll find him. Soon.
Luck? Not a factor. Somebody's gonna come walking through that door. Well, we'll just leave his passed out ass there. The Tweedle Brothers office. How much time we got left here? Oh my.
Excuse me.
What the hell are you wearing?
Hi, Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how
many 11. That's number 11.
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane.
And I think I've lost count too.
Go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal.
Maybe it is.
What brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers?
Looking for D and Dumb.
I was hoping to have a talk with D or Dumb. Do you know where they are?
No, they don't really keep regular hours as far as I can tell. Sorry.
Ugh.
It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost. He said I was just in the way.
Take the night off.
Why don't you take the night off?
That's nice of you, but I can't. I still have to clean their office.
Yeah, so do I.
I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
Sweet 105. Sweet.
I'm gonna have to take a look around.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's
not really. How's it going, Bruce Weasel?
They never told me not to let you in.
Don't worry. I won't get you in trouble, right?
Of course not, as I say as I drop a cigarette butt on the floor that he will promptly brush up.
Dear Brother Dumb, I hate dogs and you know it. Sincerely, Brother D. What's that about?
They do have their quirks.
Can't figure out which one's more of a dick, but that's a few more points for D there. Okay, I get it, dum-dums.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dumb.
Oh.
Couple of freaks. This is pointless.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them. And they really care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it.
How do you mean they help people?
They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way D explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
Or who?
All kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them.
Suppose they got any kind of packages with,
Sure, Flycatcher.
You know, magic potions or anything inside of them. I don't know. Another key.
No.
It's mine now. Well, I don't think I've used this inventory button once yet. Anyway, it's the fan. It's the crooks. The crooks! Wait a second. Oh, is that actually like 12:35? Oh, the second hands aren't moving on those. Okay. I think that actually says 7:05, but whatever.
I'm sure you have your reasons, but it's just they've done so much for me.
Well, I see they got through a nice hat. Well, yeah. Nowhere better to look than a file cabinet. A through D, that's convenient.
Ichabod Crane. He owes the Crooked Man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition. Further details filed under Donkey Skin. Crane hired them to look for a photo? Why did he want it back so badly?
He hired them to look for a photo. And they stole that photo of her from her apartment. Well, what's Donkey Skin about?
So that's why they were at her apartment. And the woodsman's place.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways.
I'm not done yet.
Detectives, like I said,
I'm finding enough.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. That's one person. No, please, just let me concentrate here.
Really, though? Okay, Cinderella. I think we've seen any of her. Damn. Crispin says somewhere in Europe. Yeah, sure, trust Crispin Glover. Of course, the guy who played George McFly.
Detective Brannigan. Keep an eye on her.
That was the detective that fell asleep because of the spell. Why would they be following her, though? I almost wonder, well, no, Crane was the one that got us out of that, wasn't he? Because he was the one that did the spell thing.
This is worse than I thought.
Oh, boy.
Shit.
Find anything?
Not what I need.
What if you're wrong about them?
I'm not.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything people say about them is true. I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people. Not that it's any of my business, but...
Is that what you think?
Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. There has to be.
I think he's standing right in front of it.
Because they're lying to you, okay, Flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives. They're hired guns. Hitmen.
Bigby, what happened to your...
Oh, geez.
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns!
Yep. I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Look, Flycatcher, I know you like them, but they're a part of whatever's happening here. They're bad guys.
That is driving me crazy that his chin beard... juts out from his face. Like, how is that physically possible?
I didn't mean to.
There's a door behind this file cabinet. Now, I don't know what they keep back here, but it might be what you're looking for.
Oh.
Well, that key you found should work.
Nice. Thank you. That's what I was looking for. Okay, it's a backwards F. See that. Oh boy. Going into Alphys' secret lab. Get ready to see some amalgamorphs. And God knows what else. He's gonna lock me in here, isn't he? Does he have to follow me everywhere? Coffee. Scales. There's a lot to look at in here. Don't touch anything.
Hold for BCW.
BCW. It's a mushroom.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane. Or the witch he was using. Something.
BCW. Let me think for a minute. You know, I'm not gonna keep thinking about that. BCW. Mushroom. Shut up, butt! You were so direct with that one. You just. It's like, it's almost gotten to the point where my butt is sentient. JD. JD Salinger.
Book.
A book?
Doesn't really tell us much.
Well, no. But it could have been, you know, James Dean.
Butcher.
Jimmy Dean. Butcher.
What is this stuff?
It's drugs, baby. Lots and lots of drugs. ASAP. Crooked man.
I'm sorry, I'm late. I'll get it to you soon. It
What?
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked Man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. You know what that is?
Care of the Lucky Pawn? No, I already took their money last time. I won't be doing that again. I don't need them to know that I've been down here.
I don't think so, but it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though.
That son of a witch. What, is there something else here?
Hey, Bigby. Do you think, after all this, do you think I could come back to the Woodlands? Since Crane let me go, I mean, I can still work here, but I don't think I want to now. I don't want to work with bad people, you know? You and Snow, you're nice.
You should talk to Snow. Maybe there's something she can do for you.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That would be... thank you.
Yeah, no problem. The hair.
Snow's hair.
Snow White? Why...
We found her hair like this inside Lily's glamour.
Ugh.
Auntie Greenleaf. This must be the witch Crane was using.
Oh, there we go.
I guess Dee and Dumb were getting the hair for Crane and sending it to her? That's not a pleasant thought.
Not really.
Auntie Greenleaf. A.G.
Do you have a phone?
Is there a phone around here? I need to call Snow.
Right over there.
Right over there on my hope chest.
Thanks, Fly.
Yeah, thanks, Fly.
I know who she is.
Just don't even say hi or anything. Just, I know who she is. It's like when Lemmy got the tumor in those Koopa Kid comics. Bowser picks up the phone. Yeah, he's like, a tumor!
It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
Wow, we're just jumping right on over here. It's 2:14. I'm 14 minutes late!
Alright, how do you want to do this?
I thought that was like going in real time. It's just... sorry, I was looking at the chat. Shoot, what was I thinking? Greenleaf, open up.
Auntie Greenleaf, I need you to open this door right now.
Oh. Cooperation.
Hello.
Hi.
What?
You woke me up.
Sorry about that.
Sorry about that, Munchkin.
Well, pardon the intrusion. I wasn't aware this was a Munchkin's house.
Well, Dorothy, it isn't.
Dorothy?
Sharp kid.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you?
What?
Just so we're not
I'm the big bad wolf.
Deary, I'm the big bad wolf.
Bigby.
Really? Wow, I've heard about you.
Have you?
Yeah, all about how the woodsman cut you open, fed you rocks for dinner, and then threw you into the ocean. And you can't even swim. Did it leave a scar? Can I see it? Are you and the woodsman friends? I heard somewhere that you guys are friends.
Actually, kid, just call me Bigby. And this is Snow.
Jeez. Oh.
Okay. Is there, is there anything you need?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, you know, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right.
Hmm.
Is there something you want?
Rachel, do you mind if I take just a quick peek around?
We'll be very quick, and he won't touch anything.
Nope. Oh. You didn't get confirmation. I don't know about this.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here. Okay, Bigby. I'm gonna trust you not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
What are we looking for specifically?
I heard a toilet flush. Somebody is here. Oh wait, that was Tom Fox subscribing for 2 months in a row. What's up, Tom? Thank you for subscribing.
No one's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check. It'll only take a moment.
I think she is Auntie Greenleaf, and she's put a spell on herself.
Let me guess. Big band or classical?
Honky tonk.
No accounting for taste.
Oh, I can't believe I ran out of time. I'm gonna be late for this thing.
Pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it.
Alright then.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain, I think.
Alright then. Sure.
That your mom?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So, yeah. So that's not really her. She's not pretending to be a little girl or anything like that.
Where do you buy your clothes? At a store? Oh.
At a store?
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Alright.
Not here.
There's no one here but me.
You got that lopsided half grin going on there. And it concerns me, it really does.
I saw a spider over there yesterday.
Oh?
A spider.
It was a pretty one.
I'm just gonna keep looking if you don't mind. Said we'd be quick here.
Do you like broccoli?
Oh?
Nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See?
Well, I still don't buy it. I'm telling you. Something.
How much longer do you think it'll be?
I don't know, kid. How much longer do you think you can hold your pee? Wait, that's a closet door. Please don't let anybody be in here.
Butcher.
The What's butcher.
That?
The baker. The candlestick
Having
maker.
To do with someone
the toilet.
Butcher. I saw one just like it at the Tweedle's office.
Oh, yeah.
God damn it.
I shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
Keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
So for a second, I thought that shadow was a knife, and she was bringing one up.
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried.
Oh, well, let me try, then. I've done this before.
No, please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
it's
that.
It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break
no,
it.
No, you don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble.
Something is right here.
Are you kidding? It's a glamour tube. Something's going on here.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me. That guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
That guy? Which guy?
I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Oh, jeez. Oh.
Anti-crate leaf.
Wait! I was right!
So when you do it that fast.
It was her. You think this is a game?
Time to waste on this shit? Think this is some kind of game?
No, I don't. But congratulations on winning it, if that matters to you.
By winning.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
Where's Crane?
Fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to. You have to know something. Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
You're an accomplice to murder. Do you realize that?
You might want to check your facts on that. It doesn't matter. I can't help you. I have no interest in being turned into a skink and crushed under boot heels.
Boot heels?
There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Man.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something...
We can protect you, okay? Whatever it is you're afraid of, we can make sure that it won't come to pass.
You have no idea what's going on, do you? Okay, you know
do
what
we?
I think we've been more than patient with you.
This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap if she's afraid for her life. We can at least make sure she never hurts us again.
What are you doing?
We're destroying the tree.
Oh my god!
How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old heads like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
And very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
Shit.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please.
Snow, it's too much. Can't ruin this woman's life over this.
Ruin this woman's life? It's a slap on the wrist compared to what she's done. Bigby, this is an order. Burn the tree.
No! Look, look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left.
Okay.
He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
The
ring?
What
does the ring do? He thinks it's the ring to dispel.
You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girls' speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
Oh, jeez.
Sorry, but we
There's
still
so much here.
To keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened. Bigby.
Please, Sheriff.
Do you really want to kill this tree for Fabled Town? Or do you want me to burn it because you're pissed off at Crane for what he did to you?
They stole my hair from my apartment, Bigby. So, yeah, I'm pissed, but I still know what's best for this town.
Oh my god.
Burning the tree, Snow.
Oh, all right, boy.
Let's go.
Hey, Greenleaf. Don't think this is over.
I won't.
Oh boy. Oh boy. Not the tree. Oh, I'm so gonna regret that. I don't know though. I feel like having it gives us more choices than not having it. Crane's car. Here we come.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss the spot? Mr. Clean, come to smash up the rest of my place. Oh,
maybe. That's gonna be your decision.
You bitch.
Out of my way.
Get out of the way.
I'm in your way, love.
Tell me what you know now.
What?
Hey, you can't just go in there. We have a problem.
Tell me.
Oh boy, did we ever.
I know you know.
Mr. Crane,
what?
Please, she can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
Get away from her.
Get away from her.
Get away from her, you bitch.
I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get the stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring goes through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all, please. I'm innocent, completely.
The ring won't work.
Innocent.
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? Yep.
No, this will work. I assure you, it must. I wouldn't. Did you
use the force?
You come on, please. Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
Oh. Now it's your turn to get the lips are sealed treatment.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many.
but I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. Oh, God.
We need to talk about the photos.
I found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. I just love you, Snow. I love you.
What?
I'm sorry. I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
Ooh. Oh.
Bigby?
Awkward.
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
I kind of didn't think so either.
He wouldn't be brave enough not to put his stamp on the world like that.
What do you mean? You don't think he did it at all? If you'd seen the room...
I don't need to see the room.
There's a lot he has to answer for.
There's a lot we all have to answer for.
This is different, Snow, and you know it.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown, of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this...
Why would he even come here if he wasn't covering his tracks?
He thought he was being framed. And maybe he is.
This fuck-up knows more than he's saying.
Yeah, he hasn't said shit so far, really.
Yes, okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily, I'm sorry, but who the hell did? You know, when I saw you come back here, I thought this was over.
Now, I know, and I'm sorry, but...
If the killer's still out there, I want to know who it is.
We'll find out who did it soon enough. Just trust us, Vivian.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you?
Ooh.
Yeah.
He may not be a murderer, if indeed that's the truth, but...
So quit your shivering.
But he's been up to some shit.
Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses.
And for suspicion of murder.
No, Sheriff.
Oh?
This can't be Greenleaf again and again, behaving however you like, acting without constraint. You have to respect this office, Bigby. And you have to respect...
Acting without restraint. You were the one that wanted to burn the tree.
You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be one minute before you have to give up something.
He said sacrifices.
So the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me.
If I may be able to give something back in return, then so be it.
I have no regrets.
Dang it.
Save your energy, huh? You're going away for a long time.
Oh, that's good enough. Oh, watch out. You're going to agitate his vertigo. Yeah, they can't even look at him. Oh, man. I'm just strutting out of here. Damn, nice silhouette, honey.
Oh, okay.
Ugh.
Stupid girls and imposter schemes.
What are you saying?
I feel like those girls are up to something. I don't know. Something about the way they were acting in that scene, it felt off. Well, what are you doing? You can just drive on... It's them, isn't it? It's Tweedledee and Tweedledum. Those motherfuckers! Don't be turning in here. You'd be too unique. We can just keep going, right? We can just keep turning around corners. Aw. What is going on here? This is getting ridiculous. Now there are two of them. Oh, damn. What the
Hi.
Hell?
What you got there?
Who are you? Oh, not these butt monkeys.
Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're... How shall I put this? Attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120-odd pounds. Pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
Huh?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now, not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking.
It bothers me that your text is in red.
Guys?
Who are you?
No, 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 no. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here. Like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
You got it.
Tweedledee, what's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Nice nose.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that?
Because
some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my
name. You in their bathrooms!
They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog.
Well, that's gross.
And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax.
Fuck
this
off.
Is my job. I like my job.
You can fuck off if you think you're getting him.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
That look on his face. Just like, I'm sorry I didn't say anything.
Fuck it.
No, 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 hey! Jesus Christ. I wasn't ready for that. No! Oh. No! Oh, jeez. Can I go back in time? I can't do... Game over.
Bigby?
Q, 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 Q. Q is good. Q is good. I'm Neo. I'm the one. I'm gonna keep pressing it. I don't care if it's full. Full is not enough. Paint your guns. Paint your guns. Whoa. Okay. W is up, right? Do I just keep pressing it? Oh, I see. I think I have to hold it. I think. Maybe not. I don't know, man. Q, 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 Q. Try the Qs again. It's fine. Oh, damn. I keep... No, I think... I don't think I'm doing this right. Oh, I'm getting... Wait a minute, though. I keep, like, getting... That was supposed to happen. This is how I achieve my ultimate form. My mega evolution. Yeah? What? I don't know where my fingers are and I can't look down for long enough to find out. Oh, damn. Yeah. Oh. Oh, you think that little thing? Oh, yeah. You got the wrong idea. I think she wanted this to happen. Where's the thing? Oops. Are you disappointed with the results of that? Well, I'm sorry to have to break the news to you. Wow, dude. Fuck it, I'm the wolf, man. He's dead. Yeah, I guess I did. Well, there goes all my chances with her. Silver bullet.
Oh God, Bigby! It was a good show. But, you know, it just didn't know when to end.
Well. Oh, geez, dude. Oh, boy. Q. We can do this.
Work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out, it's just
keep on pressing. I don't care. Oh, no. Do I need to press faster? I'll press with two fingers if I have to.
I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys.
Yeah, I'm pressing with two fingers alternating. Because I'm awesome. I can't. I don't know why I'm still pressing.
Stop.
She's sticking up for me, despite all that. Despite what I just did.
Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't
know.
Just... get out of here.
Oh boy. Now who's this? The Undertaker?
It's your lucky day, kid. The Crooked Man says it's okay with him.
Oh my gosh.
Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach?
Feeling that stomach ache, this is how a fart breaks.
Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended.
Yeah. Jeez Louise.
Nope, not like your boyfriend. Well, this is gonna be.
Oh, she broke my arm.
Relationship we have with you guys, really? I mean it. I'm jazzed about it.
Who the hell are you?
In with the new, long with the queen.
Okay.
I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
Oh my gosh, that movement with a hand. Didn't I see that earlier? Oh jeez, look at my arm bones sticking out. Is that it? Oh my god, that's it! You guys! What is this game?
He's lucky to be alive. He won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
Yeah, you're telling me.
A minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
Well,
what do you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
Yeah.
When people hear what you did to Dom, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
Well,
don't hold out.
Let them think.
Jack, you've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it.
Man, I forgot about the pig.
Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?
Oh, man. Oh, there you go. Did you interrupt Snow's eulogy? You and 80.7% of players decided not to interrupt Snow. What place did you investigate first? You and 40% of players investigated the Trip Chat Bar. I wonder if I had managed to beat the timer and make it to... What's-his-face's office. If maybe that would have ended differently, I don't know. You and 96% of players offered a job to Flycatcher. Did you burn Greenleaf Street? You and 79% of players did not burn the tree. Did you kill Tweedledum? You and 44% of players killed him. Wow, so I was in the minority on that one, just by a little bit. Dear God. What even is this game? Oh my goodness. The story gets juicier. I don't know how in the world it could get any juicier than that. Like, I am at a complete and absolute loss for turds. Or words, but turds too. That's all I got is a bunch of farts tonight. Well, sorry to say, but... Ooh, it sure is getting late though, isn't it? R.I.P. and Pizza Dumb. This game is actually pretty predictable. In some ways, I've noticed it actually is, but... But man, oh man. Can we have your honest opinion on the game up until now? I don't know if I'm really as into it as I was Life is Strange, to be honest. It is very good. Don't get me wrong. But again, that's like... This is not the kind of typically, like, not something I'm typically into. Still, though, for what it is, it's excellent. And it's got me engrossed, and it's got me freaking out at every reveal, it seems like. Or at least at the really, some of the really big ones. This is probably a good place to leave off. Yeah, it's gonna have to be. Like, I can't do another one of these tonight.